Hey guys, welcome back to Skyrim, and we're here in the Forgotten Vale where we
No
need
fair to
to
say, it would be better than this.
find the Way Shrines, I believe. And since there's a big amount of area for the Forgotten Vale, I'm going to just focus on doing the quest stuff, you know, the obvious. Oops. So I'm just going to focus on getting the Way Shrines. I'm not going to loot the place, I'm not wasting my time with that. Oh, we've got a troll over here. Oh, that's never. Oh, Jesus. Nice way to start, is it not? And dead. That's unusual, I highly think. I still haven't gotten used to only tapping the thing yet for making it appear. Anyway, as I said before, I got rudely attacked by that saber cap. I am only going to focus on getting the Way Shrines. It's too much hassle going searching out those two dragons, getting all the loot and all that crap, so I'm not doing it. I'm just focusing on the main quest. It'll save us a lot of time, and obviously I'll edit to speed it up as well. So over here is, I believe, the first Way Shrine. And what you'll find is, once you've found this first Way Shrine, the icon will move to it. And it will always move to the one that's up here. Not sure why it does, but it does for some reason. Come on, Serana. Yes, it is. Talk to the dude.
Well,
yes, we want to do this. Just give
gift,
me the.
My child.
Just make it all of this so you can see
journey
it.
To the inner sanctum.
This must be that beautiful Skyrim.
We're not in Skyrim technically. Just clear out some of this mist. I think this mist is forced at this point. So we'll just see. There you go. Icon's moved. Draw water. I think we must move on to the next one now. Why is the mist not clearing here? It must be forced until we get across the hill or something. Oops. I'm gonna walk into the trees there. And up here we go for the mist. Just clear that mist out a bit. Should be able to. I'll just keep spamming the shout until it clears because this mist is annoying as fuck. And now we have snow. No, don't rush that way, you stupid bear. Shit, I was close. Do not revive anything, Serana. I do not want to have things revived. Oh shit, get out of the way, Serana. Seriously, you're making me waste my magicka for you. And that dies, and that one dies too. Oh, nice sunny weather. Let's just clear it some more and get it lovely and sunny. I don't think these guys will have anything on them. I'm interested in those potions. Where's the giant one? Did it get thrown far down the hill or something? Must have done. Yeah, so along with not searching out all the loot, I'm not bothered by like the side tasks to this area, you know, like the ancient farmer tomes. I'll just get this one chest because it's got some useful junk around it. Like that. The skeleton should have some gold. But yes, not focusing on the loot, I just want to get the Way Shrines and get out of here. I'm hoping to get up to the battle with Verfur into this part and just get it up to there, because that'll make a good point. Because if with all the edits I do, we should reach that point. Anyway, second shrine's up here.
You've reached the Way Shrine of Learning.
Just going to move him out of the way. He's still speckled, apparently.
To honor the mantras of Ariel and fill your vessel with his enlightenment.
Why'd you think I'm here?
Ariel bless you, child, for you are a step closer to the inner sanctum and everlasting wisdom.
Why is he so speckled? It's probably Dynavision causing that. Never mind. Ah, there's the opening. I'm very surprised that the unofficial Dawnguard patch does not fix the bug with the marker teleporting. Now where the hell is it? Oh, it's there, but I can't... What the... The icon is gone from the compass for some reason. Not sure why that is. Anyway, let's progress onward and find another way shrine. I think I know where the next one is. It's above us, above on this, kind of above the cliff here. So, time for a trek, methinks. And what the dead spider just spawns out of nowhere. Fine. Down goes this frost giant that I managed to find. I think it's just got the paragons on it. I'm not gonna search out the paragons. It's a waste of time. Just up this staircase here, there's a giant there, and there's a giant up there as well. Both of them have got paragons on them. Just up at this one here, there's a paragon portal, which just basically leads to some hidden areas. One of those got loot in it, I'm not bothered. As I say, because I'm not going to go and search all out. If you want to, you can. I think in my... No, in my last play, I covered a couple of the portal areas, but I didn't cover them all, as far as I remember. Anyway, there's the next way shrine. Yes, they are everywhere. Don't know what that comment was about though, but never mind. So I've got 1, 2, 3, so this will be the fourth one. The fifth one will be up the path of the farmer. It's obvious though, is it not?
Then go forth, child. May the
I really couldn't care about Auriel strengthening me.
Undertake your journey to the inner sanctum.
Just cast spell and give me the water basin. There we go, the fourth one. And I must trek all the way up this path to find something. I believe one of the I think if you go over in that direction towards obviously where the dragons are, there's a path that kind of leads across the mountain if I remember correctly, so you don't have to go through all of this. I'm not doing that because it's just silly. Up there I think it's another giant with another paragon in it. I can't remember where the bloody paragons are. I say it's paragon because that's just easier. It's obviously not... The word is not paragon, it's paragon. And up here we go, I think. And here's some potions and gems, which I will take nicely. Yes, Dramora. I've already worked out that some people are weak. Don't need to tell me the obvious. And... What the... Oh, there he is. Oh, it's a glue marker, okay. Let's just kill this dude and be done with it. And I don't even think I'm gonna spend time looting these. It's a waste of time. Oh, that just was so close. Could have got that. Oh, just a simple farmer. This is easy enough. 2 hits and he's dead. And there's one up there as well. And that's a basic farmer, so I can just hit twice. Oh, and I've been poisoned. I'll just get in. Oh, that's nice. That's a nice death calm there. I said nice quite a few times there. Hang on a sec. Sorry, I just needed to cough there. That's why I kind of came out a bit wrong with the words. Anyway, we must progress further on into this ravine thing. No, not going into Sharp Slope Cave, there's nothing there. And another. Ah, it's above it, I know that. Stop hitting me. I don't want to be shocked, I just want to get to you so I can kill you quickly. I'll take all the potions and shit that I can find that can actually be taken. There, come on, there it was. Ah, got it. Yeah, they positioned weirdly in that little bit there, and stop shocking me, for God's sake. I want to kill you, for God's sake. Yeah, that didn't really reach. Whoops. Almost going off the tangent there. I'm taking all the potions I can find, because the potions will be certainly useful. There's no reason why they wouldn't be useful. Which is why I'm looting only the potions and not bothering with anything else. Only bothered by useful loot to me, not the junk. Just heal up quickly. I do hold it on for a bit longer because it does glitch up a bit when you're healing. Oh, a Shadow Master, that's not too good. I don't really want to be dealing with a Shadow Master on my own, to be honest with you. Because I don't have the magicka for this. And if I just keep him away, it'll work. We'll deal with him like so. Ow! I'm poisoned again, I think. If I am poisoned, it's not good. I'll just wait for my companions to catch up. Wherever they're at. Must be down below somewhere. Ah, I could just storm on ahead without their help. And in here, nothing. And I don't think there's anything up here. As far as I know. No. My two Dremora have caught up with me by spawning, I think. They weren't there a minute ago. Yes, we've got challenges near us all the time, don't we? Oh, another Gloom Lurker, okay. And it looks as if they took out one of my Dremora. Oh, never mind. No, you won't be feasting on anyone's hearts, Dremora. Just die. Jesus. That did quite a lot of damage, I can tell you. Just heal up quickly. It's good that I've got the perk that means that restoration spells do more effect, which is good, and that they don't I can't remember the thing as I tried to find the bloody marker for this poxy. I'll just take that. One of these will have the potion. Ah, there it is. Right, so I've got that book thing. I didn't really want to pick it up, but I picked it up. I've got no choice. And the way onward is over this way. I picked up just a place so I could get to the marker points. Yes, I was just saying, I've got the part that means that my healing spells do more effects. Like, healing, the basic novice level healing does a lot of effect. And I also got the perk where my health regenerates, my magicka regenerates at full rate regardless of whether I'm in combat or not. Which is actually a good perk to have. Which is why I use Spurg. No. And he's using a ward, not helpful. I hate it when Palmer use wards. Because then I have to whip out the sword. And take their soul. And we go to Glacial Crevice. I don't think we'll be spending too much time in here. As long as I don't dither about. Oh, look, that red looks of the flames looks very realistic. If I just look at this, that looks really nice compared to the rest of it. So, the mods are certainly doing something to help with the lighting in this place. There's a lot of armor in here, I'll just say that right now. I'll just attack these guys, though, just to get rid of them. If I just do that, that'll do a lot of damage, which will help, though. And there we go. That was easy enough. That was close, I could have fallen off there. And oh, there's a Gloom Lurker. who will be dispatched fairly easily. And someone's shooting arrows in my back. Oh, it's some farmer from behind. Sneak attack, sorry. Nope, not doing that. I always like the Ice Dungeon music. It's a nice calming track in my opinion. And interesting, you'll notice I'm not using candlelight, which means that this doesn't really need it. Which is strange because in RLO, Realistic Lighting Overhaul, this place was pitch dark. Although saying that, it is daytime, so that's probably why it's even lighter than it normally is. Just get that out of the way. There they are. I'll just hit this gloom worker a few times and he will die. Oh, he's got a Chorus, how nice. And this one is pretty strong. Oh, balls, got hit. Let me just get the bound sword out. Save me a load of hassle. No, don't heal. No healing from you, please. Just take that little bit of gold since it was worth it. And there's another farmer just up there who just gets out of the way of my attack. Let me just do this. And that did nothing, I don't think. Oh, there we go, that hit. I'll just do that. That'll work! Area of effect for the win. No, I'm not going down there to look at the loot chest, don't care. I'll just do a double one. That kind of worked. It didn't really work the way I was intending it, but never mind. No, don't poison me. I hate it when I get poisoned, it's annoying. No, don't you dare. I'll just hit you a few times and you're dead. Easy as pie. Just activate the tripwire and dodge. Simple stuff. I'll just deal with this guy in like 3 hits. There we go. Now I believe we have to go through this passage on the right. And no one here. That's good. I never remember the exact route to get to this thing. Yeah, we're going the right way. I'll just look at this one chest since it's here. Silver ore. Don't really need it. Now, you're probably wondering what's going to happen after Dawnguard. I did say at the beginning of this part when I'd start to do the Dawnguard stuff that I would be moving to Wormstooth. So, yes, what you're going to see is a change of character after I'm done with Dawnguard. I'm going to move on to Wormstooth with Macnook. Then I will come back to this character. I'm not too sure what I'll do with this character after that. But we'll see. We'll see what happens, really. Because I need to just check out what I'm going to be doing. Because I want to leave Undeath for a bit. I may actually... No, because to do Undeath, I really need 100 enchanting. And at the moment, I don't have that. As you can see, I only have 79. I need to max this out up to at least this the perk for Sagacity. Which is basically skill enchantments and armor is 25% stronger. I cannot remember what other mods I've got installed that are quest mods. I'm pretty sure I have a few that I just installed and can't remember it offhand. I know that I have a few possibly for Macnook, I'm not sure, but I may go back to main quest and just complete it off. Get onto maybe Dragonborn and then just complete off Undeath Last or something, I don't know. I am starting to get towards the end of the Let's Play really. In terms of content, because once I've done Wormstooth, there's nothing really much else to do. If I just check, I've done Hanging Gardens, Helgen Reborn is basically done. Undeath Isn't, and Wormstooth will be done with Macnook anyway, so there's that. And with Wormstooth, that'll be full coverage. I'll just do it all as much as I can. And then we go back to Skyrim again. I think once I'm done with Dawnguard, I'll take a small break, then come back. Once I've gotten into Fallout 4 and the other Let's Play, I won't mention just now, but essentially, what I want to do is kind of... Oh shit, that was a dumb idea. And you can just die, farmer. But yes, what I really want to do is kind of take a break from Skyrim, enjoy Fallout 4 for a bit, as so I dealt with this one. Note, you can die. Yeah, so I'll take a break from Skyrim when I'm done with this, which is only going to be this part and the next part anyway, so that saves hassle. When I come back to Skyrim, it will be with Macnook on Worm's Tooth, and then I'll come back to this character. Oh no, don't you dare heal. Oh, here's another. Bomber, oops. I know we've got another one who's using wards, don't. And die. Yeah, these farmer are dying pretty easily. I'm pretty sure there's something of interest up here. Yes, potions, and it's the strong variety, which is what I like. Which is why I'm taking them, because I'm going to need them. And there's some more. Definitely take them. Oh, I'll just take that soul gem as well. I'm not going to loot any more. Quick save here, because I know this is a bit of a nasty section. Not bothering to clear skies, what's the point? And there's a... I will now just do this, which will do an incredible amount of damage. Apparently, but it's not really done that much. And down! And who's shocking me still? I'll just temporarily cast this. And then die to me. Oh, it's a grand soul, that's nice. And that lagged a bit there for some reason, and I think we've awakened something down here. Oh no, we haven't. Well, that's good. I'm not going near those things there, because I'll just awaken Taurus. I don't want that. There's at least nothing at all. Or waste, and I've gone the wrong way. There's another farmer tome that I don't need. Oh, that's an interesting one. I'll take that ring. And then, and the unused one at least. Which is the way on? Oh, I think we have to go below, don't we? Which will mean I will just have to do this to get them awakened. Because I have to come down here. And they will be here, right in front of me. Die, Chorus, Hunter, Fledgling. Don't poison me with your whatever it is. And here's another one. Shit. Where did he come from? And I'm being poisoned and I am stuck. Good. Honour me a bit more. I think it just goes a bit dark here for some weird old reason. Don't really know why, but it does. I actually play without the HUD on now. It's actually quite an interesting one, just holding it down when I need it. It's far better. Let me just bring light up temporarily. Just because I can't really see clearly in this. And there's nothing up here, which is good. Just watching out for any traps. I know there's one nearby. Ah, there it is. Just kind of come up here, folks. I'll just pull that trap. I don't mind if the Dremora kind of leg it. Well, I do mind if Serana does, and fuck, the boulders came down in the most awkward position possible. Just kind of push these out of the way. It's annoying when even your own character's got to shove stuff to... And here's another fucking Chorus, Jesus. What the hell? That was a weird bit of lag. Let's just rush out of here and get on with this. Oh, and here's the last one. Oh, and it's a nice sunny day.
You found the Way Shrine of Radiance.
I'm moving it to the side because of that blurriness that comes from the Dynavision.
And fill your vessel with his enlightenment.
Yes.
May the blessings of Ariel protect you as you climb the road to the inner sanctum and final enlightenment.
Just give me the bloody ball, for God's sake. At least it's a nice day. At least I can't complain about that. Right, we've filled it. That's good enough. Now I think above us there are some potions I'm going to want. So I'm just going to take them. Because every little bit helps in the final battle against Berfer. Must be up on this one. Ah, look at this. A ton of potions, just perfect. Take them all because you'll need them. I'll just jump the lazy ways down. Ah, look at that. I'll just wait for Serana to get down here. Well, I'm not waiting. She can go and fuck herself to get across this bridge if she wants. I definitely like this place where it's not misty and cloudy and all that shit. It's better when it's nice and clear. I'm just going to jump over here to get a little bit of minor loot that I know that is very hard to get to, simply because I've used it once before. It's the rubies on top of this skull. Oh, that was close. I got them all. There we go. It's a couple of flawless gems, and it's a good way of getting flawless rubies for something in other quests, but might as well just get it anyway because it's useful. I can put it into gems and shit. Now let's just rush up these steps and get into the inner sanctum so I can battle Verfer. Because I know that with my fire abilities, I will be able to defeat him rather easily. And of course I've got two Dremora Lords that help somewhat. Here's Serana. Just gonna wait for the light to activate. And then the door handle to just turn so we can get in. Now I know that there's some useful stuff that we could take like that. I'm going to put... No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to put this up. There are some hidden passages around here which I recommend you take if you've not got very good gear. Simply because they'll lead to some useful potions and things. An elixir of health that just disappears all by itself. There's a sword. A skull that will cause some frozen shamans, and they die in like several few hits because they're resistant, they don't like ice, which is obvious. Yeah, over there is a little passage that just leads to some loot. Not bothered by it. If I die like loads of times, I'll just reload a save and then use it. Oh god, he dies in like one hit anyway, so yeah. Why would I need a scroll of a conjure flame match knack? That's just dumb. Spell tome, knowledge is power. That is certainly an apocalypse spell. And I'm just going to take it because why not? Let me just see what does it do. That's interesting. Copies the non-concentration spell in your left hand, granting a power to cast a spell once a day for no cost. That is rather interesting. I'm going to try that, I think, maybe after I'm done with Dawnguard. Or at least when I come back to this when I come back to this after thingy. After I'm done with Macnook, that is. Oh, Serana. Let's get rid of your stupid skeleton that I don't want. Necklace of Minor Health, dies to the... I mean, it's literally one hit and they're dead. I mean, it's crazy how quick these things go down at. I'm not taking the War Axe. Over here, I believe, is some useful stuff that I'm going to take. There's a... Looks like, I'll take that Scroll of Grand Healing, because it's useful, but I don't think it's going to work in this case. They put a lot of useful health related stuff around this area. It's deliberately done as an indication of the fact you're probably going to have to fight a lot. Walk in here, these should come to life. Oh, when I take this circlet, they will. There we go. Goodness. No, die. Yeah, these die rather quickly because they're ice, so they obviously don't like the fire that burns them quickly. Before we go into the main area, I'm just going to go round here because there's a chest with some more potions. Like, how many potions do we have? I mean, look at all those potions of health. I mean, it's crazy. Excuse me a sec. Sorry about that. Build up a saliva in my mouth. And on we go into the Aurel's Chapel, I believe it is. Yeah. And, yeah. I'm gonna quick save here because why not? Nothing over there, just leaves a dead end that says you can't go this way. Just rush in and talk to Verfer.
Did you really come here expecting to claim Ariel's bow? You've done exactly as I predicted and brought your fetching companion to me.
And she's away back there for some reason.
Which
now, where the hell is Serana? I really hope that she's not like far behind glitched out. Alright, get down here, Serana. Get in. But let's just cast these two. They'll help. As will this. Now let's just kind of dive in. And just like do a bunch of damage. A bunch of frozen Chorus for some reason. He must love the Chorus. There is Serana in there. Ah, there she is. That's good. Now this is actually kind of good of a choke point, right? Come on. Here comes more. Frozen things really aren't going to succeed against my fire. Now I'm going to just do this because it'll do a lot of damage. Like that. I'll do like just like one of those every so often and then just cast normal spells, right? And since I'm running out of magicka, I will just take a potion. It's a good thing I've got a bunch of them. This is a good way of wasting them all, I suppose. This is actually better with fire spells, in my opinion.
An impressive display, but a wasted effort. You delay nothing but your own death.
Really?
Watch out! He's falling down the ceiling!
Yeah, well, good for him. Is he? Ah, there we go. I had to get a bit closer to him before he decided to pull the ceiling down, apparently. That's an interesting thing. There's some frozen farmer who are going to die pretty quickly. Well, they should. And I just got hit. It was dumb. Let's just cast two of these, despawn them. Oh no! And I've not really got that much magicka, and he dies. Oh, that was... Yes, this has gone long enough. I'll get in there, the pair of you. The three of you, actually, is probably the better term. Yeah, this is going to go fairly easily if my casting doesn't glitch. And there's another frozen farmer who will perish. And die. And I'll just take another potion. Because why not? And I'll just help you out here, Serana. There you go. On to the next target. There and down. Well, it's doing a master conjuration spell, basically. Right in front of the Dremora, who do not apparently flinch. I like how this is all about just me and her. It's just like silly.
Come on.
Yeah. Fine. I'll just quick save here. It's good enough point, isn't it? Oh, look at this. This is a nice way to have an ending battle at 7 o'clock at night on this balcony.
Enough, bro. Give us the bow.
How dare you? I was the arch curate of Ariel, girl. I had the ears of a god.
Until the betrayed corrupted you. Yes, yes, we've heard this sad story.
Where's the sun setting at?
Gellibor and his kind are easily manipulated fools.
Really?
Look into my eyes, Serana.
Why are you going back into that clutching phase again?
You're a vampire? But Ariel should have protected you.
The moment I was infected by one of my own initiates, Ariel turned his back on me. I swore I'd have my revenge, no matter what the cost.
Really?
You want to take revenge?
So you created this prophecy, basically.
Ariel himself may have been beyond my reach, but his influence on our world wasn't. All I needed was the blood of a vampire and his own weapon, Ariel's bow.
Stop looking at me, just look at him.
Ariel's bow? It was you? You created that prophecy?
A prophecy that lacked a single final ingredient, the blood of a pure vampire, the blood of a daughter of Cold Harbor.
All this time for someone with my blood to come along. Well, too bad for you. I intend on keeping it. Let's see if your blood has any power to it.
Quick save. And now let's just kill him. And like... Oh, Dremora, don't get in the way, for God's sake. No, I'd have now contracted Sanguinary fucking Vampiris again. Oops. I meant to bring this up. He was quick at giving me it, wasn't he? Now, why the hell do you have, like, so much health and I kill him before he can use any health? Okay, fine. Down he goes. Why the hell does he have a Grand Soldier? I thought he would have not had one. Strange. Not taking any of that. I'll take this stuff, though. I'll just leave him to have his ancient farmer garbage, basically. Hello, Gellibor. Before I do that, I'm going to just take one of those cure disease potions to get rid of the Sanguinary Vampiris that I do not want.
So the deed has been done. The restoration of this way shrine means that Vertha must be dead, and the betrayed no longer have control
of it. Sorry to say, well, the betrayed weren't involved. He was a vampire.
What? What are you talking about? A vampire. I see. That would explain much.
Yes, it would.
Deep inside, it brings me joy that the betrayed weren't to blame for what happened here.
Why do you care?
Because that means there's still hope that they might one day shed their hatred.
Shed their hatred. That's very unlikely to happen, I'm afraid, Jeff.
It's been a long time. I'll not
insult your ambitions, but that's got no chance of happening.
You risked everything to get Auriel's bow, and in turn, you've restored the Chantry. I can't think of a more deserving champion to carry it than you. If you wish to learn more about the bow, or obtain sun-hallowed arrows for it, I'd be more than happy to help. You've
not getting sun-hallowed arrows. If you want to see what it does, I have a video on it. Right, I think it's like at the end of my Let's Play that I did before, where I basically did this stuff I needed for it. Restoration has gone up to 65, which is good. We're on the next quest, Kindred Judgment. But...
I trust you're faring.
Yes, I'm faring well. You're going to have to wait for the finale of this Dawnguard coverage in the next episode. Oops. I'll just put my character right there and leave you here on this balcony at the Chantry of Auriel. We'll speak to Serana in the next video. Bye now.